Welcome to DKW Demolition. I am here with the number one contender for DKW British Championship, Rohan Blake.
Thank you for having me.
You're more than welcome. So, we recently saw at the Loaded event, you defeated Taylor James in an Ironman match to become the number one contender for the British Championship, which, as we saw, ended in a bit of controversy. Sam Dufresne is the champion, so do you have a message for the DKW British champion, Sam Dufresne?
Well, I personally believe that Sam Dufresne, even though he is a top contender in DKW, his reign needs to come to an end because the dirty tactics, the way he carries himself as a champion, we need a new face, a new beacon of light in DKW. And Harry McDonald, bless his soul, he did try his best, but he came just a little bit too short at Leon C. So, I think it's time for someone else to step up, and that person is me, the marvel of magic, technician, magician, Rohan Blake.
So, as we've seen, nobody's been able to defeat Sam Dufresne at the moment, so what makes you think that Rohan Blake is the man to dethrone Sam and become the DKW British champion?
Well, I'll say it like this. I mean, Sam is a competent fighter. He is really strong and really powerful, but I've learned his style. I've learned from his match against Harry.
Whoa. Did somebody say number one contender? You can't have a number one contender without talking about the life coach, Lucas Jackson. I won that gauntlet match, and I should be the man to become the champion. So, Mr. Rohan Blake, I know it's honourable that you decided to become one of your idols and win an Ironman match, but I'm afraid I beat you. I won a gauntlet match. Fair and square, I won. Not the Hobbit way, me, the life coach Lucas Jackson.
I mean, since there's now two number one contenders, I feel like surely we should settle the difference, no? I mean, you won your match, even though it was a little bit a while ago. I've won my match, well, it was like 2 weeks ago now, so if we're going to say anything about that, I should be number one contender.
The life coach doesn't share. I am the number one contender, and though what, if you won't give me that spot, let me take it from here.
Given me the authority to make a match. So what we're going to do, we are going to settle this in this ring. Life coach, you are going to team with Tiger Style to take on Rohan Blake, Axel Woods, and Benny Nitro tonight.
Hey, that's
bring on. Bang
my quest, me to your face, yeah. Seconds, I ain't got time to waste, yeah. Everybody put their hands up in a place, yeah. Everybody put their hands up in a place, yeah. Bang my fist, me to your face, yeah.
So highlights of that big six-man tag team match that I've just announced will be coming shortly to Instagram TV, so make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss out on that action. That's right, guys. I am Danny James. I am here presenting Demolition to you in the absence of Jazzy Josh. So, for this six-man tag team match that will be shown on Instagram TV, it's not going to be the whole match, just some highlights. We are going to see the debut in-ring of Axel Woods when he teamed with Benny Nitro and Rohan Blake to take on the life coach Lucas Jackson and Tiger Style.
Everybody put their hands up in a place, yeah.
So, guys, we have a very special edition of Demolition here. So, Happy New Year, everybody. It is me, Danny James, and I am here to present to you this Big Max, big, tasty episode of Demolition, where we are going to feature Harry McDonald versus Lucas Jackson from back at the event known as New Independence Day from Leon C. And we're also going to show you Harry McDonald taking on one half of the Rebellion, Jack Torino, in what was an amazing match and probably is going to be the stepping stone for Harry McDonald's trajectory up the DKW ranks in 2022.
So this contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, the life coach, Lucas Jackson, accompanied by Danny Daniels.
So Robbie, here comes Lucas Jackson and the hooligan Vinny Daniels. Two men that have been running riot on DKW for years now.
I mean, running riot is a very strong use of words there. I'd say they know their business, they're happy doing what they do. I don't say they're running riot. They're strong working men, and you know, you need to respect that grind.
One question.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Why has Lucas Jackson got Italian flags?
He's got a mic, so let's be quiet and let the man speak and we'll find out, I guess.
Now, I would usually say it's a pleasure to be here somewhere like Lean on Sea, but right now we have an announcement to make. I'm afraid, Mr. Announcer, you got it wrong. As we guess, we are the life coach and the hooligan, but we are not representing Lee, we are not even representing England. We're representing the greatest nation on earth, Viva Italia! European champions won the Eurovision Song Contest, and we even beat the Caribbeans at 100 metres of the Olympics. With the best schooner. So I'm here to declare tonight I am the life coach, Luca Jackson, and my tag team partner tonight will be the hooligan Vincenzo Daniels.
Danilo!
Vincenzo Danilo!
Going back to my Italian roots!
And tonight, or this afternoon, I'm going to put the whooping and the hurting on a certain Big Mac, Harry McDonald.
No one here has even heard. Well, I don't need a mic. I don't need a mic anymore.
Oh, Robbie, and here we have the hometown heroes, Harry McDonald and Charlie Brooks.
What is this about?
The Brotherhood.
And now they're touching. And oh, what a way to disrespect the Italian. That is disgraceful.
I mean, it's nothing that Vinny and Lucas wouldn't do.
No, they wouldn't. They would treat you with respect exactly how they did, and they hung it over there. But that is disrespectful and disgraceful.
What's Charlie Brooks got in mind here? He can't decide what to do with the flag. I mean, Vinny Daniels and Lucas Jensen understandably look fairly upset. Hang on. Lucas Jackson and Vinny Daniels trying to start it off early, but the Brotherhood getting the upper hand there with a pair of super kicks for them. Now taking it outside the ring. We now have Danny Jackson joining us on the commentary table, which is something new here for us. So, Danny, tell us, how did this match come about?
Yeah, so obviously, first of all, thanks for having me, guys. Harry McDonald, obviously, we know him as part of the Brotherhood, but we know that Harry has said that he wanted to branch out into a bit more singles competition. And, you know, obviously,
a two count there from Harry McDonald.
That was quite close, yeah. Harry obviously wanting to advance into like the singles division a little bit more. And, you know, he debuted 2 years ago now. He's been a former Chaos champion. And, you know, maybe he's got his sights set on some bigger things in the singles division. Obviously, Lucas Jackson will just be looking for a fight with anybody. And, yeah, obviously, coming out with the Italian flag. I know for a fact that he's not Italian. I mean, obviously, I don't talk to him much because, like, he's banned from destructive interviews. You know, if you have watched those online, you would have seen that I actually banned him when I did my interview with Chris Hunter. If you've not seen them, go back onto the DKW page over on YouTube. There's interviews with most of the DKW stars on there. But yeah, the one I had with Lucas Jackson, with Chris Hunter, sorry, he just kept interrupt. And in the end, it was like, look, I don't want you on this show anymore. So yeah, he's not really a guy that I speak too much. But yes, all I know is that he's not Italian. Harry just wanted a fight with someone in the singles match. You know, Lucas wanted a fight, and obviously we know, you know, the man at ringside in his corner, Vinny Daniels, one of the most decorated guys in DKW, is obviously going to be a big, big player in this match, I feel.
I've no doubt about that. Now, Robbie, as you know, Lucas Jackson is highly decorated here in DKW himself. And, hold on, Vinny Daniels getting involved in this match already. And Charlie Brooks here coming to the aid of Harry McDonald. So, as I was saying, Robbie, Lucas Jackson decorated in his own right here in DKW. Do you think that will give Harry the advantage? Not necessarily the advantage, but it would be a considerable upset and probably boost him in the eyes of DKW management?
I mean, if he can get the win, then sure, that's definitely going to boost him. But Lucas Jackson always has an ace up his sleeve. Well, not that he's wearing sleeves, but he always has an ace or an idea. You know, a plan B of action is always there. Like the life coach, as I said, giving life lessons, and you think the life coach isn't going to have a second option or a plan A, B, C, or D, it's going to happen. So I'm intrigued to quite see what's going to happen.
One other interesting thing, though, guys, that I did notice when I was backstage was there were constantly leaflets lying around for this stupid life coach program. It said something on it about $14.95, and Lucas trying to sell this life coach program to people still. I mean, I've not heard him mention it for a while, but, you know, I understand he was going around in the locker room putting leaflets in everyone's bags for it. And it's like, mate, just give it a rest. Nobody wants to join your stupid life coach program.
I think $14.95 is a steal. It's a bargain. You know, I'm just waiting for the opportunity for when it comes to me, and I'll happily sign up.
Lucas Jackson's certainly given Harry McDonald some lessons here. Oh, Lucas Jackson giving Harry McDonald some lessons on trying to drag the life out of him. Oh, Lucas Jackson there, just using those ropes to his advantage, choking Harry McDonald. Oh, look at this. Lucas Jackson just digging his heel into the lower spine of Harry McDonald. That surely has to do some damage.
It's got to be doing some damage. It does not look like it's something that you want to receive or be on the receiving end of. Now, look.
Harry McDonald fighting back now. Maybe the momentum that Lucas Jackson picked up isn't going to last long. Big boot there, and Harry McDonald just seems to be getting back three times what he's giving.
Ooh!
Harry McDonald with the big back elbow there to Lucas Jackson. Now the big boot there. Oh, and a nice crossbody off the top. One, two, quick kick out there from Lucas Jackson. Harry McDonald seems like he's got something in mind, possibly going for that running knee of his. No, he goes for a super kick instead. Oh, and Lucas Jackson with that clubbing blow to the back.
Oh!
Oh, and now with that sent on to the spine. One, two, oh! Harry McDonald manages to get his hands on the ropes. Now Jackson driving McDonald down to the mat with those forearm blows. Oh, what a big headbutt.
That's a stiff headbutt. I mean, not that there's much in between Harry McDonald's head for him to feel much, but that he's definitely going to feel something pinging around in his brain there.
Lucas Jackson may have wasted a little bit of time there, giving Harry McDonald that breathing space that he needed. Oh, maybe not. Jackson, the momentum seems to be firmly in Jackson's corner here.
Does it indeed. Is he calling for an end?
Very possibly. Oh, going for the bear hug here. And he's got it locked in. Just look at that expression on Harry McDonald's face. Not only the pressure being applied to his spine, but... Oh! He gets out of it. And a big lariat there takes the life coach down. Big back elbow. Harry McDonald goes up to the second rope. Oh, and a big missile drop kick there. Takes down the life coach. Now going for the pin. One, two. Barely kicks out at 2 3/4. What else has Harry McDonald got to do here to keep Lucas Jackson down?
Up.
Oh, a fake out super kick there, then one to the gut, and then one to the jaw. One, two, and another kick out for Lucas Jackson. Vinny Daniels got up on the side of the apron there, looked like he was about to get involved. Harry McDonald getting the crowd on his side once again. Oh, Vinny Daniels getting involved as usual. Oh, and a low blow there from Lucas Jackson. Come on, this is not how you're supposed to win a match. Now going for the Boston Crab here. Harry McDonald trying to get to the ropes. Lucas Jackson dragging him back.
Gonna get it. And
oh, and Harry McDonald taps out. However, he wouldn't have been in that situation had Lucas Jackson not gone with a low blow. So, Danny, what do you make of that? Lucas Jackson winning by deceitful tactic, shall we say?
To be honest, nothing surprises me with him anymore. He knows he's been in this business a long time, since I think 2004. So he knows every trick in the book. You know, referee's back turned. Lucas is obviously going to take advantage of that. You know, and Harry McDonald, still obviously in the relative youth of his career, is, you know, still going to be learning. But I think the more that he's in the ring with the likes of Lucas Jackson and Vinnie Daniels, etc., you know, he'll know when these kind of things are coming. So he'll know exactly what counters to use against them.
What are you telling me, dropkicks? I am the Big Mac, Harry McDonald. And, you know, let's just address the elephant in the room here. I'm a failure. I am. Let's not try to sugarcoat it or gloss over it. I mean, first of all, let's acknowledge the fact that Lucas Jackson and Lewis Barrett have drawn a gauntlet match. I don't know why that's happened. What do you mean drawn? Drawing a gauntlet match, brilliant. That's what we needed. And then on top of that, obviously, Rohan Blake, the guy that I just beat at Westcliff, he's now going to compete for the British Championship. And I can't even hate on him. I can't hate on him. We're at talk after that match. He's earned my respect. We went to the limit. We pushed each other to different points. And I won. I did win. But look where it's got me now. And this is the thing that I keep struggling with in my head, is the fact that no matter what I do, I am a failure. Let's look at what I did. I come into this business. I'm part of the Brotherhood, the most promising tag team in Dropkick's history in the UK at the time. And when we finally got the opportunity to win the tag titles, I didn't do it. I fell short. And why is that? Why did I fall short? Let's delve into that. Because later on, when I got a Chaos opportunity at the Chaos title, brilliant, with Maverick Mayhew, Jack Torino, Jaden Williams, people who are excellent at that game, and I lost again. And then now I come back from lockdown, and I genuinely, I'll be real with you, I sat there in training, I sat there imperfectly on the mats, and I said to myself, can I do this anymore? I did not know, and I did it. I pushed through and I got to where I wanted to be. But does it matter? No, it doesn't matter, because I lost again and again and again. And Sam Dufresne is still champion. So I cannot blame him. I know right now I'm at the back of the ladder. And just look at how I'm living right now. Let's just take a quick look at how I'm living. Does this look like a champion's living state to you? No, I didn't think so. And I don't want to sit here and just whine all day like a little... But at the end of the day... At the end of the day, it's hard when you wanted one thing your entire life, and the second thing, the second that it became a possibility, I lost. And now, what do the Dropkicks want to do? They want to throw me right at the end of the year, on my birthday, into a match with the Drifter Jack Torino. And I can be honest with you, I really, really don't need that match right now. He is probably the best pound for pound competitor in DKW, maybe in the UK, and that's what I get right now. And you know, most people would see it as a blessing. It really is great to step in the ring with someone like that. But I didn't need that right now. I did not need that. And I don't know if I can beat him. I don't know. I don't know why I've gone around the last 3-4 years calling myself the Big Mac, the main man, because I've let all of yous down. There was a guy in the front row called Alex Price, and he held up a Big Mac sign. He came there for me. He came there for me. And what did I do? What did I do? I let him down. That's what I did. And I just don't want to let any more people down. So I'm going to face Jack, and I'm going to give it absolutely everything I have. And if I don't win, then maybe then I guess that wrestling just ain't for me. The following contest
contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, he is one half of the rebellion, the Drifter, Jack Torino.
How you doing out there? It's me, the Drifter.
That's right, guys. We are here with Jack Torino taking on Harry McDonald. Harry, obviously, just off the back of probably one of the most heartbreaking defeats in his young career against Sander Frain. And, you know, the ending of that match, if you've not already seen it, is just, it's something else. And talking of Harry McDonald, here he comes.
And his opponent, he is the main man, Big Mac, Harry McDonald.
This young man with a very, very bright future ahead of him.
I want to say thank you to everyone who come out to lead. Look, I'm sorry I let you down, innit? Sorry.
Harry McDonald there apologising to the DKW fans, and you know, any DKW fan would say, look, there's no need to apologise. You know, this young man put in such a great performance against British champion Sander Frain.
Bombastic, Dan! Bombastic!
And we are underway in this contest. Harry McDonald and Jack Torino meeting, I believe, for the first time inside a DKW ring. This contest, remember, is taking place after our loaded event. And Jack Torino coming off of a huge victory against Sir Selfie. Harry McDonald seemingly won the British Championship against Sander Frain. But a decision between obviously myself, Matt Ball, and the referee Alex Devonport meant that that match was actually overturned and Sander Frain was declared the winner. Torino here. Torino getting Harry McDonald on the mat, showing the experience.
One match. Get over it, eh?
Listen.
You ain't got to think about that. You're in it with me. Don't want that big oath. You don't want to do...
Oh, both men exchanging slaps there. Harry McDonald, nice takedown. Drop kick straight to the head of Torino. One, two, two count there, Harry McDonald. Bit of forearms there from Harry McDonald in the corner of Torino. Oh, and Jack Torino, that experience charging at Harry McDonald in the corner. What's Torino going for here? Springboard. Nice move there from Torino. Mocking Harry McDonald there, calling him pathetic.
Why are you clapping?
Yeah, that's what I thought.
God, you want to get up so bad, you want to fall, hey? You seen this?
Jack Torino coming in there. Oh, sent on there from Torino.
He's worried about that, mate.
Again, Jack Torino mocking Harry McDonald, saying he's worrying about Sander Frain.
think she's saying he should be worrying about him, not Sam Dufresne. Harry coming back with rights and lefts there. Going for a cutter, pushed into the corner from Torino. Kick to the face there from Big Mac. Oh, and Torino catches him from the top rope. Oh, ribs to the knee. Oh, lovely slam there from Jack Torino. Going for the cover. One, two. Two count there for Torino. Jack Torino again, you know, he was due to face Lewis Barrett at Loaded. Lewis Barrett didn't show up to that match, so his opponent was changed last minute. Was Sir Selfie making his first appearance in a long while here for DKW. Oh, and Jack Torino has... Harry McDonald's shoes just come off. Oh, putting the sweaty shoe right in the face of Harry McDonald there. Must taste like one of those cheesy Big Macs. Oh, picking him up by the hair. Obviously not so Harry can utilize that tactic. Lovely suplex from Torino. One, two. Another two count there. Again, Jack Torino mocking Harry McDonald.
Come on, one. Come on, no.
Oh, that would be fun.
Come on.
Two.
Come on, you're off the head. Come on.
Two. Oh, that
would
be fun. This is for you, DKW management. Two stone pile driver, yeah?
That's the forbidden move.
The forbidden move.
Forbidden move in DKW here. Jack Torino looking for a tombstone pile driver. Harry McDonald rolls through. One, two. Oh, two count there.
Not that fast either.
Oh, beautiful hurricane runner there from Harry McDonald. Ducks a clothesline of his own from McDonald. Back elbow. Now the drop kick. And Torino comes back in. Oh, super kick to the head there from McDonald. And Jack Torino rolling out of harm's way. That veteran experience from Jack Torino rolling to the outside to get a bit of a breather from the relentless assault from Harry McDonald. But wait, Harry is on the apron. What's he going to do here? Back at it. Crossbody from Harry McDonald to the outside of the ring. And Harry throws Torino back in the ring. McDonald going to the top rope now. What is Harry McDonald thinking? Oh, he goes for a nice frog splash. One, two. Two count only there from Harry McDonald. Jack Torino again, the veteran instincts kicking in, able to kick out. Looking for that big tasty knee.
Ready? Yeah.
Oh, going for it. Torino's caught him. Back down. Got a waist lock. Back into the waist lock from Torino now. Two men exchanging waist locks there. Harry pushed into the corner. Torino's got him up on his shoulders. Beautiful move there from Jack Torino. Torino not letting Harry catch his breath. Best moonsault ever here. Oh, well, it would have been, I think, if Harry McDonald hadn't got his knees up.
One.
Both men are down.
Two. Three.
Remember, if they can't answer a 10 count, this match is going to be declared a draw.
Five. Ah, six.
Referee at a count of six now.
Seven. Eight. Son of a bitch. What was that? Come on.
Men exchanging strikes. Oh, Big Mac fires up here. Forearm set aside at the head. Oh, big forearm rocking the jaw of Torino. Oh, discus. Oh, another pump kick there from McDonald. Back elbow. And a beautiful discus clothesline there from Jack Torino. Ooh, that was a 2.5 count there. 2.5 count there from Jack Torino, nearly winning. Torino setting up for that door. Move that ended Benny Nitro's hopes last time. Looking for the gore. Oh, but Harry McDonald scouted it well. Moved out of the way there. Torino scouted that well. Oh, beautiful. 619 around the bottom rope there. Taking the legs out from Harry McDonald. Oh! What a lovely cutter that was from Harry McDonald.
Not like last time.
Not like last time, he's saying. I'm guessing referring to this match and the match against Sander Frame, where eventually he did hit that move. Running knee attempt. No. Torino reverses. No. Into the ropes. Oh, big tasty bicycle knee. Torino straight up again. Big tasty bicycle knee. Here it comes. And the third hits. 1, 2, 3. That is all she wrote. Harry McDonald victorious here against Jack Torino.
I'm back, baby. Listen. Maybe I started off rough, but I'm back now. You see that? This guy's doing all up in the UK. All the companies.
So there we have it, guys. That was the big, tasty Big Mac episode of DKW. Thank you so much for tuning in. Don't forget, guys, go on over to our Instagram and our Facebook pages. We are also going to be on TikTok. So don't forget, guys, to keep checking us out all over social media and keep an eye out on our Facebook page and our Instagram page, where you'll get the latest up-to-date ticket information for our live events coming in 2022.